Hello, I'm Benny Finch, a man with a dream. A dream to bring the great games of the 2008 Summer Olympics to the great metropolitan town of Barstow, California. Ladies and gentlemen of the International Olympic Selection Committee, let's face it, Barstow, a popular city and a popular state, is much more popular than the other less popular cities you're currently considering. This little tape being taped for me by the fine folks at Little Al's Video Shack will show you the kinds of culture, scenery, sports places and stuff that are available here in my hometown. I'm convinced once you see what we have to offer, you'll think of Barstow as a true Olympic city. To get a true taste of Barstow, I thought a good place to start would be the Benny Finch household. This is my lovely wife, Molly. She's my inspiration, my soulmate, my lover. We first met a few years back when she was working as a showgirl at our local truck stop. It was love at first sight. Molly's always been behind her man. She was behind me in my dream to become Barstow's leading male manicurist, and now she's behind me to bring the Olympics to Barstow. We're pro family all the way. Where will the games be played? We start here. This facility will facilitate all swimming and diving events. The beauty part? The swimmers will also stay in this athlete-friendly motor inn. The pool's shortness of length poses no problem. The average dull four-lap event will become a thrilling and tactical 112-lap test. An unfair advantage for those swimmers good at turning? We'll let the 10 billion television viewers be the judge of that. Tennis and wrestling will be played here. Notice how our fences have been designed with holes, so spectators can get a good view of the action from all sides. This is the Barstow Sportatorium, the jewel of our facilities. Not only will all track and field, soccer, and other Olympic activities be activated here, but it will also be the site of our opening and closing ceremonies. Notice as well the prime space for selling trinkets and fried sugar bread. I believe this is a plus. Every Olympics has its local legend performing in front of the hometown fans. Barstow 2008 will be no different. This is D'Angelo Shumpert, the finest athlete in Barstow. It is his dream to bring a new and thrilling sport to the Barstow Olympic Games.
I'm just one of the many people who demand that the fine sports of skipping and prancing be added to the Olympic Games. These beautiful and feminine sports can no longer be denied. Skipping and prancing combines strength, hand-foot coordination, and flexibleness. I hold world records in both sprint skipping and long-distance prancing. I think the Barstow Games will be the perfect place for the world to embrace these pretty sports.
Now, you're probably thinking to yourself, everything sounds terrific, Benny. Your plan is aces. But what about food and lodging? Not a problem. Our exotic town is blessed with many charming motels. What does the Olympic athlete crave? Fresh meats. Barstow is famous for its special desert meats such as goat, lizard, and the sweetest of all meats, sand mouse. Plus, our international cuisine rivals anyone's. Every Olympics has one thing in common, a cute, cuddly mascot, and Barstow 2008 will continue that tradition. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Prick, the Barstow 2008 cactus guy. We'll have stuffed Pricks, posters of Prick, plastic Pricks, every cup, hat, collectible, everything will have our sweet little Prick emblazoned on it for everyone to see. I've told you about my dream, but I haven't told you how it ends. In my dream, I'm taking the last leg of the Olympic torch run into the Barstow Sportatorium as we hear my wife, Molly, sing the national anthem for an audience of 14 billion screaming fans.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight.
All right, I'm okay. Slow practice is all. See you in 2008.
Our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star spangle banner yet wave? Or the land of the free and the home.